Tiger Kickoff Show is back. Same show, new crew as we get going here in 2024. We've got all the coverage of Missouri's football season underway. It starts here against Buffalo. I'm joined today by the Missourian crew and Adam Busack, Davis Wilson, and Amelia Hurley as we get ready to match up against the Buffalo Bulls here in week two. We have full coverage in a matchup that Eli Drinkwitz says is going to be a difficult one.
Going against him, you can always expect the unexpected with Coach Limbo on that side. So, you know, really got a tough challenge ahead of us, and, you know, looking forward to that challenge on Saturday.
With that said from Eli Drinkwitz, before we dive into this whole matchup here with Buffalo on it being a tough matchup and everything that happens here in week two against their MAC opponent in the Buffalo Bulls, let's break down what happened here in week one against Murray State. Starting with you, Adam, what did you see against Murray State?
Well, Jacob, you have to take everything that you see in these kind of games with a grain of salt, right? You're playing against inferior competition in a team like Murray State. So obviously your offense is going to have a lot of success and your defense is going to have a lot of success as well. However, I think even grading on that scale, Missouri's defense played very, very well. Less than 100 yards given up, that'll play no matter who you're matching up against.
Yeah, we saw six matchups across Power 5 football be decided by 50 points or more. And Drinkwitz, he talked about that in his press conference on Tuesday, talked about the transfer portal and other factors. But the biggest thing is freshman linebackers got in the game, and it tells you that these young guys, they're really trying to prove themselves. And when you hold a shutout, that's a whole team effort. So very encouraging for the Missouri defense, a defense that after losing several key pieces, had some questions here in 2024. So encouraging. Davis, I want to ask you what you saw about that defense here in the matchup against Murray State.
Yeah, I mean, the defense statistically right now is the number one defense in the country, held their opponent to less than 100 yards. I think you saw a defense that was able to shut down the run. Again, an inferior opponent, the Murray State roster. The Murray State offensive line really didn't have a lot of continuity, and the rotation of the Tiger defensive tackles were able to kind of get in there. We saw Chris McClellan get in there for a sack, force fumble. So, yeah, I think they were able to bring a lot of pressure and disrupt that Murray State offense.
And you guys keep using this term, inferior opponent. I just want to put some things into perspective. Mizzou has never lost to an FCS program in their history since that came in, like, the late 70s, I think it was. I think it was 79 when FCS and the bowl division split off. Missouri, the last time they lost to a non-Power 5 opponent was Wyoming in week one of 2019. So these upsets, they're not common. They don't happen a lot. So inferior, it's a good term to describe what we saw in really what was a beatdown, 51-0. Can't characterize less. You don't want to do it disgrace or a serve, especially when you pitch a shutout against the Murray State team. But Amelia, I want to ask you, what did you see from the Tigers' offense, Brady Cook? Brady Cook, he had 228 yards, a touchdown. Obviously, he's pulled after the first half. But what did you see from the offensive side from the Tigers?
Yeah, I mean, with a 51-0 shutout, there's not much more you can really ask for. And with Luther Burden, with that first touchdown of the season, I think a lot of fans are real excited about that. But I was really interested to see the Lightning and Thunder duo that we had heard about all of fall camp, which was Marcus Carroll and Nate Noel at running back. I think they did pretty well. We also saw a bunch of players after that come in with Kewan Lacy and Jamal Roberts and everything. So it was really great to see the depth that the Tigers had.
I think, too, one of the fun things is it's almost like a money ball strategy. You have Cody Schrader, this guy that was a All-American. He goes to the NFL. He was just recently cut from the 49ers, picked up by another team. You have a lot of production to replace, and you go money ball style, and you bring in two guys to replace that production. And we saw both those guys have success. Noel, he had 48 yards. Carroll, 35 yards, a touchdown. So both these guys, they played well in week one, which is as to be expected against a Murray State team. But transferring over here to Buffalo, I want to start with you, Adam, here as well. What are you expecting from the Missouri rushing game, especially in a game that Missouri is very heavily favored in?
Yeah, I think this Buffalo defense, really, we can get into it a little bit more later, but this defense is going to give you some interesting looks, right? Joe Bowden is the defensive coordinator for Buffalo, a very young guy, brings a lot of fresh approaches to defense. Sometimes you'll see nine players in the tackle box. Sometimes you'll see him stacking up the defensive line like that. So it's important that Missouri has some strong carries to kind of set the tone early, or else they're going to have to rely on their passing game all day long. I think Marcus Carroll really profiles more as a bulk back than Nate Noel does. I wouldn't be surprised to see him get the majority of the touches in this game.
We see, too, there's almost a need to beat down on these teams a little bit, especially in the early schedule. You look at Michigan. Missouri is ranked higher than Michigan right now after Michigan kind of floundered in a 30-10 victory. They played well. They were able to win the game by 20 points, which you see that in the box score, and you're like, oh, yeah, they handled that game. But early on, it looked like Michigan was struggling. So for Missouri, you want to assert your dominance early here against Buffalo. My question to you, Davis, is will Missouri's strategy, will Missouri's final game score be similar? Will it be the same story as the game against Murray State week one?
Yeah, I think Buffalo is a tougher opponent than Murray State, but I don't think they're a great team, not a team that kind of stacks up against Missouri super well. You know, it's going to be a blowout again. I expect it to be at least. So I think Missouri is going to probably, Drinkwitz talked about how he wants to play the starters the whole game, but if he needs to, he'll pull them early like last game. So I expect a game where Missouri is able to take advantage of an inferior opponent.
And Drinkwitz, he mentioned that this was going to be a tough matchup. He knows Pete Lembo, talked to him several times at NC State. What is kind of your sense here? Is this kind of coach talk? Is this more so something that Missouri actually needs to be concerned with? Obviously, every team in the first couple quarters, they're going 110%. But in your opinion, what do you think of those statements?
Yeah, I mean, it's a little bit of coach talk, but also Buffalo is tougher. And they, you know, like their offense was able to rush for, I think, over 200 yards against their week one opponent in Lafayette. So that's something to watch. They had the MAC Defensive Player of the Week and Sean Dillack, linebacker. That's another player to watch. Drinkwitz emphasized that they need to focus on him. So I think that they're a tougher team. It's a little bit of coach speak, but they should take it seriously.
What are your thoughts on that, Amelia?
Yeah, so Sean Dillack specifically is someone that I was looking into this week. He's a linebacker, and he missed most of the 2023 season due to a shoulder injury. But in 2022, he led the country in solo tackles. And then they also have Marcus Fuqua, who is going to be a safety on the team, and he led the country in 2022 with the most interceptions. So those are definitely going to be some key players to watch, for sure.
When it comes to Missouri in this matchup, obviously, like you mentioned, Buffalo is not going to be the biggest challenge of the year. Boston College next week, that might be a question so far. See, they've looked really good. But in the eyes of the AP poll, in the eyes of fans, what needs to happen for this week to be considered a win for Missouri? Is there a certain point threshold? Is there a certain storyline in the game? Does Brady Cook need to throw for over 200 yards? Does Carroll and Noel need to combine for over 100 yards rushing? Does the defense need to pitch another shutout or hold the team under 10 points? Are there any thresholds or numbers that you're pointing to that would mean success for Missouri against this Buffalo team?
Well, Jacob, you know that I'm kind of a numbers guy, but this time I'm going to take the numbers and I'm going to leave them at the door, right? I'm going to throw them away. And I'm going to use a term that I don't love using, but I think in this case applies very well, and that's the eye test. I don't necessarily think there's a threshold of points that Missouri needs to get to. I don't think they need however many passing touchdowns or rushing touchdowns or anything like that. If they come out and they look good and there's never a point in the game where they seem like they're going to lose, I think that's going to be more than enough to convince AP voters that they got it right by moving them up to 9, and maybe they need to be moved up even further.
When you see Missouri sitting at 9, 11-4, hop up two spots after week one, obviously helps if Florida State falls out and all these things happen. What does that make you feel, not even as an analyst, just as like fan of Missouri football?
I mean, it's cool to see. Missouri hasn't been this highly rated in the AP poll often in the last decade or so. So it's good to see that Missouri football is kind of on the up again, and Drinkwitz has it going in the right direction. And I think this week's game against Buffalo is, like Adam said, a really good chance to prove it to the AP voters that they're a top 10 team.
To you, Amelia?
Yeah, you know, I think that after last week, something that fans would probably want to see more of is seeing Brady throw more. You know, we didn't see as much of that passing game as I think a lot of people would have liked to in the first game. I think if we can do that and the defense can also keep doing what they're doing and be number one in the country, then I think that would be a solid win.
I think one of the nice things we've seen, Amelia, from this Missouri team over the last 2 years now is that this receiving core is largely the same. We saw Theo Weiss come back for another year. We see Cooper come back for another year. And obviously, Luther Burden, we've got him one more year before he hopefully goes top 10 in the next draft coming up. So what is that like, the continuity of this Missouri offense? Is that something that you've seen here earlier in the season through week one and hopefully playing into week two, or something that this Missouri team still needs to build?
Yeah, so I was here for fall camp, and Drinkwitz spoke a lot about how important it is not only to have the whole receiving core come back, but also the offensive coordinator, Kirby Moore. And I think that we really saw that last week against Murray State. There was a lot of familiarity, a lot of continuity in that. You have your starting quarterback come back with that receiving core as well. There's going to be that familiarity there. So it's nice that they were able to focus on the running back game and be able to have that continuity in the other areas.
So with that all said about the players, there's a question I've got to ask. Who's cooking? All right, welcome into Who's Cooking, the only segment in Missouri history where we hold a pot and a ladle and talk about the players we expect to boom and Missouri's upcoming matchup. I'm going to start with you, Adam. Just like in third grade, you hold the pot and the spoon, you get to talk. Everyone else is quiet, and we get to hear your thoughts about who is going to be the boom player in week two.
Well, I think we would be completely remiss if we started a segment called Who's Cooking and he didn't start with Brady Cook. I mean, come on. The name is right there. It's such an easy joke. He's the captain of this Missouri offense, the team, the quarterback. Amelia, you had a wonderful story on him last week. I think this time this year, as compared to this time last year, feelings around Brady Cook are completely different for Missouri fans. I think the fans are behind him. The team is certainly behind him. I think he's going to have a great game. Davis?
All right, I'm going to go with Christian Williams, another captain of this team on the defensive side of the ball. I mentioned earlier that Buffalo rushed for over 200 yards in their week one win. The defensive tackles are going to have to plug the gaps, make sure that the Buffalo running backs, quarterbacks can't run all over the place. And I think that Christian Williams is going to be a big part of doing that.
Before you put the dish down, Davis, I got to ask you,
sure.
What specific dish are you cooking? If Missouri, if you were to bake a dish
for
Missouri football, what dish would it be to describe this matchup against Buffalo?
Very interesting. Yeah, I think it is sweet. Maybe like a cake or maybe a pan of brownies. Maybe a cherry pie. Yeah.
All right, cool.
A dessert, I'd say.
Cool. We'll get yours later, Adam, I promise.
We'll loop back.
So I would say I would say Chris McClellan. From last game, he had a sack, two solo tackles. The Florida transfer, he came in and just really dominated with that defense. So I think if we can get more leadership from him and more plays from him, we can keep up with that number one defense in the country.
Right on, right on. Adam, we got to ask you, what dish?
I need my pot.
We'll come back to you. We'll hit it in a circle.
Well, Jacob, we're going up to Buffalo. We're playing the Buffalo Bulls. I know that we're talking about Bulls, but we're also talking about Buffalo. Buffalo Wild Wings, these guys are going to get cooked. Missouri is going to win this game very handily. Back to you, my friend.
Amelia, I got to ask you your dish as well.
You know, I think it'll be a sweet victory for Mizzou. And, you know, thinking about up there, I would go cheesecake. A nice, like, New York-style cheesecake.
Cheesecake.
Plain and sweet and good to go.
Cool. Well, obviously, every big player has big plays, and that's what's coming up next. Our next segment, Adam's Big Play of the Game. Welcome in to Adam's Big Plays, where we'll see Adam Buzak, our senior analyst here at the Tiger Kickoff Show. I'm just kidding. Adam's going to break down all the plays here. They're called big plays because Adam's got that big brain. Adam, let's see what's in store from last week, Buffalo against Lafayette, and how it relates to this week against the Missouri Tigers on Saturday.
Well, Jacob, our first play that we're looking at here, I'm going to go ahead and run it, is a throw from the second drive from Buffalo. You see that quarterback, CJ Ogbonna, looking to the right side, and right there you see a completion made. We're going to go back a little bit to the start of the play here. You're seeing man coverage from this Lafayette defense, but he's going to throw right here to the top of the screen, and the quarterback is looking that way. Oh, hey now, is looking that way the entire play. As you can see, a ton of anticipation there. Not a great tackle made by Lafayette, but hey, they are Lafayette. This is a similar play that I want to show you from Murray State. We're going the same direction, throw the same way, and there's Toriano Pride just jumping the route because he has that anticipation. We'll go back a little bit, and you see the same thing from the quarterback. He's looking that direction the entire play. Pride, reading the eyes, is able to step in front and make that interception. If that same thing happens for Buffalo this week. I think we're going to see a lot of that from Missouri. Now, here's a bit of a better throw from the Buffalo quarterback, Ogbonna, looking for the corner here. Here's Taji Johnson making a beautiful diving catch. Now, this referee is going to say that he was out of bounds, but on review, this was ruled a touchdown. This is a perfect throw. Beautiful anticipation and a great catch by that cornerback. That's another key for Missouri this week, Jacob. You can't let plays like this happen. You're going to need safety help. You got to get your man out of bounds. Once again, beautiful catch, something that Missouri is going to be weary of.
Especially with these two corners that have shown success so far, Norwood, and we've also seen great stuff so far from Pride, but the Missouri secondary going to be a part of a key emphasis of this Missouri matchup against Buffalo. Adam, thank you for your big brain and Adam's big plays. All right, well, Adam's got a big head for a reason. He knows all the knowledge there on Missouri football. We'll transition over now to our keys to the game as we get ready here to figure out what needs to happen for Missouri football to get a win over these Buffalo Bulls. We'll start with Adam, who jingled his keys very nicely. Adam, what are your few keys to this game against the Bulls?
When we look at the quarterback for Buffalo, CJ Ogbonna, he's somebody that Missouri has seen in the past, a dual threat quarterback. This is the first of three consecutive weeks that they'll see a dual threat quarterback. So I think the key for Missouri is going to be containing him.
Yeah, he had nearly 100 yards when they faced him in 2021. It was a point of emphasis for Eli Drinkwitz. Davis, is that a key player for you as well?
Yeah, absolutely. He's a quarterback who can run the ball really well. And Missouri's about to face a stretch of quarterbacks who are a bit dual threats. So figuring out it here against Buffalo with CJ Ogbonna could also mean good things down the line.
In what world, what would need to happen in order for Buffalo to edge out an upset victory over Missouri?
I think it would just be Missouri can't figure out how to stop a dual threat quarterback. We saw last year against LSU, obviously much different. Jaden Daniels is not CJ Ogbonna.
Number two overall pick in the draft.
Not the same Jaden player Daniels. At all, but we saw Missouri's defense struggle with him as he was able to run. Ogbonna is not quite the thrower that Daniels is, but that would probably be why, if they just couldn't figure out how to stop the run and Ogbonna.
Ogbonna went 14 for 24, threw for 195 yards and two touchdowns in the 30-13 win over Lafayette. I want to ask you, Amelia, is he your player in this game that Buffalo needs in order to win?
Yeah, you know, I mean, he's definitely one of them, but I'm going to lean more back to the defensive side of the ball and go with Sean Dolak. I think that he has shown with his Defensive Player of the Week at the MAC conference that he is one to watch for. We talked about his threat with tackles in the Marcus Fuqua with interceptions. Missouri really needs to win the turnover battle in this game. They got to protect the ball. They can't let any slips happen or else you're up to them.
And for Missouri's side on the keys, you mentioned the turnovers. Is there anything else that they need to do well or just do it all? Because honestly, I feel like Missouri will have a lot of mulligans in this game. They can have a couple turnovers, and just because of the talent, just being in the SEC and having the profile of the top 10 team that Missouri is, they can make a couple mistakes and still win this game. But to preserve that top 10 status that Missouri has and not make this one close, what keys does Missouri need to do to keep this game kind of in style of being a top 10 program in all of college football?
You know, I think it would be nice to see Cook work on that passing game, get some more passes in there. I think that is such a dominant part of Missouri's offense, and to not have that could be a big risk for the team. They also need to go back to the basics and work on limiting those penalty calls. They had 9 for 56 yards against Murray State, so being able to go back to the basics, clean those up, don't leave any room for error for Buffalo to take advantage of that is key.
And I think that's kind of the purpose of these games early on against, I don't want to say easier, but like we mentioned earlier, easier FCS and FBS opponents. Is college football doesn't have a preseason. You know, in the NFL, they get 3 or 4 games, depending if you have the Hall of Fame game, to try to figure out your offense and connect and get pieces to mesh and work together. However, in college football, week one is week one. And we saw, obviously, Florida State has learned that the hard way. They've had 2 losses before week one is even over. So for Missouri, this is kind of figuring out the pieces offensively and defensively, getting together and kind of having, I don't want to say their preseason, but their version of trying to mesh before these big games on our schedule, like Oklahoma, like Alabama, like Texas A&M, and Boston College could be a big one that we're talking about next week as soon as, you know, a couple days. So With all that said, I want to ask you, this is the most fun part. What are our score predictions? Will Missouri be racking up the style points against Buffalo in a couple days?
Well, Jacob, it's going to be hard to crack that 50-point margin in two consecutive games. Frankly, I don't see Missouri doing it. I think they're going to have a very strong game. 50 is just a little bit too high of a mark to get to. For me, I think the Tigers are going to get to 42. That's six touchdowns. That's respectable. For Buffalo, I'll spot them about 14, but that's about all that I see.
I'm pretty close to Adam. I had 42 to 13 in this game. Again, six touchdowns. One touchdown for Buffalo, a couple field goals is all I can really see him.
Yeah, you know, we talked about how Buffalo's defense and Buffalo as a team is going to be a bit of a notch up against Murray State, so I'm going to go 45-10 Tigers.
I was going to say, I'm right there with you, Amelia. I got 48-10 Missouri. They take it all the way. I think we see Carroll. I think we see Noel. I think both those guys get touchdowns. I think Brady Cook's got at least one touchdown, maybe mixes in a rushing touchdown as well. I wouldn't be surprised to see it. All right, well, that will do it for week one of the Tiger Kickoff Show. The predictions in, it's locked. Hopefully we don't get blinded by all the points Missouri puts up on Saturday. Thank you for everyone tuning in and supporting the Tiger Kickoff Show. We'll be airing bi-weekly now for the rest of the 2024 season. Yeah, that's right. You can watch us every Monday night, every Thursday night for the rest of the year as we preview and review every game on Missouri schedule. Want to thank again our wonderful, amazing Missourian beat reporters Adam Dusak, David Wilson, Amelia Hurley as we close out episode one of the 2024 Tiger Kickoff Show. Thank you everybody for tuning in. We'll catch you on Monday.